consistently appreciating and awarding the Nigerian youth for their hard work, tenacity, and consistency. Today, we are live at Terra Culture for the 25 Under 25 Award with the 6th edition themed The Future is Now. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you your red carpet host, Adebimpe Olajiga. Trust me to bring you everything happening today. I'll be interviewing the guests, the nominees, and every other thing you want to see. Make sure you don't blink because you might miss the most important thing.
Baby, when you leave, I'm not gonna leave, oh. Girl, I wanna stay here with you, oh. Mama tell me, make a steady live life. Make her know the Jones, make her day here for you, oh. She tell me, say, now you, they make me slow down.
Still in the mood of celebration and excitement, I have this amazing lady with me. Oh my God, you look beautiful. Turn around. No, 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 no. Come on. Your Nigerian is Nigerian.
Absolutely.
So can we know you?
Okay, my name is Gloria Olufeko. I'm a nominee under the media and communications category.
Oh, wow.
25 under 25, 2021.
Wow.
I'm a radio presenter at Africa Tech Radio.
Okay.
Yeah, so basically that's what you should know about me.
Oh, you don't want to tell us the full gist? There's something you're hiding?
No, no, really, there's nothing I'm hiding.
Okay.
No, no, fingers crossed.
Mm-hmm. So is that the only thing you do? You're only a radio presenter?
Okay, yeah, so I also do voiceovers.
Okay.
I am a red carpet host. Okay. I was actually supposed to be at a red carpet event, but I couldn't come because I have to be here.
Okay.
And basically, I teach how to speak English.
Oh, wow.
So to say codes.
Oh, wow. That's nice. That's exciting. So can you tell me the process of voting? How was this for you?
Oh, wow. It was laborious, really, really stressful. But I mean, from the you have to ask people to nominate you,
exactly,
up until you have to ask them to vote for you. Then there was a postponement of the voting process.
Yes.
I mean, I said postponement. It was extended,
mm-hmm,
and at the point I got really tired. But you know, we have, mm-hmm, to keep on doing it.
Mm-hmm.
Then now we are here finally to know who won the.
Okay, so the quick one, if you announce the winner, just show me how you're going to feel, how you're going to react, and how excited you're going to be. Let me see.
Okay, let's
see. So now the winner is Gloria Olufeko. Is this how you're going to do? All right.
I would really be so excited.
Okay, then you give me that fish, yes, dance. Come on, they are not ready. All right, I wish you the best
thank
tonight.
You, thank
Have
you.
A lovely, lovely, lovely
thank
day
you,
and enjoy
thank
yourself.
You, thank you.
Bye.
Thank you, thank you.
So I have another amazing man here with me and he looks like an angel. Wow, wow. White.
Thank
Come
you.
On.
Thank you very much.
Are you
thank
sure you're not a Yoruba demon?
I'm actually a Yoruba guy, yeah.
And the Yoruba demon thingy. Oh, praise the Lord. Yoruba angel, wow. So what's your name?
My name is Ayodeji Falitu.
Oh, wow. So are you a nominee or a guest?
Yeah, a nominee. Two categories, professional service and another one actually, but professional service.
You can't even remember. That
I think,
means...
hospitality and tourism, yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
yeah, okay, yeah. Okay. So what do you do?
Okay, so I have a 9-to-5. I work in a financial institution.
Okay.
I also have my side business, which I am nominated for. Careers and business everything. I do civil services, okay, trainings, and upbringing for youth and young professionals.
Oh, that's good to hear.
Yeah.
So how did you go through the nomination process, the voting, and how you're here to get today? How was the process like?
Apparently, I did not know much about this. One of my customers told me,
okay,
and he was like, he saw something on SME Africa and he wants me to be part of it. So they created the link and they started sharing for people to nominate. So when I was getting big, I had to involve myself and here I am today.
Okay, well, so if you're announced as the winner of the category,
wow,
how are you going to react? I want to see that. You're laughing. I've not even pronounced you the winner. So how are you going to react? Let me see. So the winner for the professional service is Mr. Ayodeji. Drum rolls, please.
Thank you.
This is how you do.
I don't know what to do.
This is what you will do.
I'm very happy. Okay.
Come on, you dab.
Yeah, okay,
you dab to victory.
Yeah, sure, I'll
all right, thank you so much for joining me on the red carpet. Have a lovely day. Bye, y'all.
Bad girl, a touch of my ready rich. Can you make me feel some type of way? I feel your love is on the.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this moment, forget the fact that I told you my name is Adebinkwe. Right now, call me King of Boys. I have three able men here with me, and I would like them to introduce yourself. I'll start from my right-hand side. What's your name? Okpemikpo. What's your name?
Oluwanipemi Downsi.
And what's your name?
And I'm Emmanuel Oluwagbemi.
Okay, Emmanuel. So I'll ask one after the other. Are you a nominee or a guest? How about you?
Nominee as well.
I'm a nominee as well.
Oh, wow. In what category?
I'm technology.
Technology. Yeah. So what do you do exactly?
AI and I focus on web technology.
Okay, you said AI. What's the full meaning of AI?
Artificial intelligence.
Okay, thank you so much. What about you?
I run a non-profit organization, which I started when I was 13.
Wow.
Which just basically trains young people, provides digital assets, digital skill acquisition programs.
Okay, when I said I was in the midst of and people should declare me as the king of boys, it seems like the age. I need to start asking. How old?
So I'm now 18 now.
Wow, what about you? Okay. You're 15.
Wow.
You're 15. I have a 15-year... I am the king of boys now. So exactly what do you do?
So my organization, basically, what we do is provide access to digital skill acquisition programs for young persons.
Okay.
Because we found out that there's a huge gap in the education space.
Okay.
And we found out that many young persons are not employable.
Yeah.
So we're providing them digital access, digital skill acquisition programs.
Okay, so what do you think about tonight's awards? Do you think you have put in enough effort to be declared as the winner?
Well, I got nominated last year, so I'm a 2020 nominee.
Okay.
But if I was to win the award, yeah, definitely, most definitely. I put in enough work.
You put in enough work. How about you, Mr.
Okay, I won a business plan and open, and I help businesses thrive better in the market space with the right strategy and service on this.
Okay.
So we are a team of six. We are a team of six of young professionals, and we render some services for small scale and medium scale business owners.
Okay.
Now we are into data analytics and consultancy. We are into business plan and development, and we are also into some a little of tech related aspects pertaining to business growth per se.
All right, that's nice. Now I'm coming back to you. So what exactly do you do?
I'm a developer advocate, actually. So what I do is advocating for different organizations I work for as a developer. I share codes. I work on contributing to different communities, most especially the IBM community. And that's basically what I do as a developer advocate.
Okay. For your age, when did you start? At what age did you start, and how has it been?
I started at the age of 10, and it's been a very rough journey. It's been a very, very rough journey. All because we live in a society whereby, a society that criticizes people and it's been a very tough journey, actually.
Okay, were you inspired by someone? Is it that you have a brother or your parents are into it?
My parents are not into it. I have someone like a brother, Tanbi Bakshi, and of course, someone here.
Okay.
Yeah, he actually inspired me.
Okay.
Okay,
that's nice. Good to meet you guys. Thank
nice
you so
you
much.
Well.
I wish you the best tonight. And I also would like to ask, if you are declared as the winner, I want to see your reaction at once. Okay. How are you going to react? One, two, ready, go. What about you? You just smile. You are just going to smile. All right, thank you so much for joining me. I wish you the best of luck, Ray. Bye. Gotta be doing something right.
Jubilation, no, celebration. celebration where we gon' do for our life. We go day or die to overeat. My low, my lola, my rally, my rally, my jay, my ramoto. I'm a no quibo, she luto. My low, my lola, my rally, my rally, my jay, my ramoto. I'm a no quibo, she luto. Yeah, 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 yeah. You go play, you get patience. Clean out, I don't like pretense. I want a blessings within my location. Bad mind in my circumference. They go do, they go hear nonsense. I know send that they for high vibration. Oh, you need my low, my lola, my rally, my rally, my jaye, my ramoto. I'm a no quibo, she loto.
This is the
non-new
reception. I want to, on behalf of SME 100 Africa, I congratulate you all. This is the part where we hand over your nominee certificates. I want to first of all say to all of you, please put your hands together for yourself. Out of 3,500 plus nominations this year, you were able to shortlist to, I think it's the first time we have nominees over 100. The very first time. And because it was tough. It was tough for us this year because I think you guys are doing amazing things. So without wasting of your time, I would big welcome the head of the divisional coordinator for BI for the Lagos State Internal Revenue Service, Mrs. Abiola Akigede, please. Ms. Abiola, welcome to have you.
But you have actually decided to make the best of what you have within the country, display the talent, the kind of things you can do to make a difference, to get out there and be proud to say that you are the ones that are making things happen. I'm so proud. We have here so many beautiful faces, so many designed dresses, gowns, African attires around. I met a lady in the washroom and I told her, look, this is beautiful. You made this. She said she did. That means there's a lot of hope for us in this country. And you are the ones that have started, and you started it, and you are going to continue. There are no places you get to in the top organizations now that you meet in the 70s, 60s, except in politics. But in politics, now you don't need much of your brain. You are the ones that will take over from the politicians because you have the brains, you have the wherewithal, you have the vision, and you have the mission to do it. I congratulate every one of you, those that are going to get the awards, and those that have tried, and those that are still hopeful that things better will still come their way. Thank you very much, and I enjoy yourself.
Sorry, please. Well, I'm going to present the first set of nominee certificates. So just hand over to Jolene. This is Mr. Akiden will help us present the first set.
So I'm going to start with the software and design. I have Olawale Badewa for software and design. Olawale Badewa. Get your certificate. Then we have for food and drinks Adeyinka Adejumo. Adeyinka Adejumo. Adeyinka Adejumo. Anyone representing? Okay. We have Runyi Ukuma. Ufemia for music. Daniel Benson, music as well. Daniel Benson. Akombi Bamidele Brett, for music as well. Akombi Bamidele Brett. Michael Adebayo for music, Michael Adebayo, Tosi Akinminu. Alright, please let's start with him. Next we have Munna Odunaye, Media Communications. I'm so sorry, forgive me. Then we have Jordan Jola, Media and Communications. Jordan Jola, Media and Communications. Okay. Ibiyemi Matthew, Media and Communications. Ibiyemi Matthew. Ibiyemi Matthew. Please let's clap for them. We have Ade Dayo, Ade Loye, Media and Communications. And we have Gloria Olufeko, Media and Communications.
Please join me as I make welcome Karika.
Karika is going to talk to us about you. Karika, please don't stop clapping for Karika. Don't stop clapping.
Good afternoon, everyone. Hi, my name is Karika, and I'm the VP Programs at SOCOM. And, you know, I mean, for everyone who is here, for everyone who has nominated, please, I don't know what's in your hands, just put your hands together for yourself. Like, really, you need to give yourself a pat on the back for how far you have come. It's amazing, you know. And I like to think that when you think of your dreams, what would it take you to achieve your dreams? What, I know a lot of us here have the big things we want to do. December is coming. You're like, oh, this year is almost coming to an end, right? So what are the things that would have stopped you from achieving your dreams this year? Is it a network? Is it your network? Is it connections? Is it knowledge? Is it money? Right? And the very fact that you're here, the very fact that you are either celebrating people or you are being celebrated here is something that is really, really noteworthy, right? And I like to think that all of these things, at SOCOM, you know, we really understand because we've been on this journey ourselves. When you think of SOCOM, SOCOM was founded by two young people just like you. I mean, not that old, but when they started, you know, they were exactly like you. They've been on that journey. We understand the uncertainty. I mean, I read a piece few days ago on Instagram about this appointment, about, you know, right, putting up a project there that doesn't scale true. We understand all of these things because we've been on that journey. We understand the habits, we understand, you know, when it looks like other people who have zero potential of what you have, but they seem to be making it big. They seem to be having all the likes on Instagram. They seem to be getting all the grants. We understand all of these things, right? And in view of that, we have something, we come up with a program called LIFT. LIFT stands for Learn, Improve, Focus, and Transform. And it's really a journey to take you from where you are to where you need to be. That's big, I want to hammer. Whatever that is for you, that's how we take it for you. At SOCOM, we like to think that we are partners of potential. We see the things that people do not see. You know, I don't even know in Nigeria, in the world, nobody knows you until you hammer. And then everybody says, oh, she's my uncle's sister's brother's friend. We went to the same school. You know, everybody shall look for a way to connect to you, right? But we see you before you even get there. And while we are encouraging you, first of all, on this journey that you are on, I mean, 25 and 25, it's amazing. Like, I'm amazed at how people so young can do so many big things, right? I mean, I don't know what I'm going to say. But I mean, you guys are doing something big, so well done. And then also, so we're here to encourage you on this journey, and we're here to invite you, you know, I'm sure Charles has talked about some of our products and things, you know, use forms, all of that, helping you get your data research and all of that. But most importantly, we're inviting you to join us in this journey of LIFT. We're here to lift you up, we're here to lift your business as well. We're here to take you through knowledge, so giving you relevant knowledge that's important for you, information, money. I'm sure everybody here wants money. Who doesn't like money?
Make it just bring the back home.
So, you know, giving you money, and most importantly, mentorship. See, in my life, if there's something that has helped me in my journey, right, when I think of my life, when I think of how far I have come, if there's something that's helped me on my journey, it's having people mentored, having people ahead of me that have helped me. I mean, the mistakes I have made have been minimal just because I have people who have helped me on this journey. So I'm inviting you to join us. Find out more about the program. Check out www.socom.xyz/lift, right? You see amazing testimonials of people from all over Nigeria who joined the first cohort, who have gone to their next level. And I mean, that happens to them, it can be you. So join it now and let's get your business lifted. And finally, again, I'm here to remind you that you are the value. So wherever it is, whatever it is, when you're in that tough situation, when you're in that difficult state, when people give you a laugh, when you don't have money, whatever it is, never forget that you are the value and you're a superstar. Never forget that. Keep shining and stay lifted. Thank you.
Shobola Ademola Andrew, photography. Shobola Ademola Andrew.
I need you.
Please, Ukonu Ogechi Performing Arts. Ukonu Ogechi Performing Arts. Cindy Edger, Kadiri, Technology. Jude Kadiri, Technology. Please give them a round of applause. Benjamin Dada, Technology. Benjamin Dada. Open for this Technology. Oswald Okoji, Sports. Oswald Okoji, Sports. Jordan Warren, Sports. Josh Okoji. Oguyomi Ayomide Samuel.
Guys, thank you. Please let's a round of applause for the special assistant to the governor of Ogun State. Please let's make welcome one of my closest allies. He's the chairman of the biggest advertising agency in all of West Africa. Please a round of applause as we make welcome Mr. Shay to the room. So also we have the executive director of the Terra Onosaya Foundation. She's somewhere around. She's going to be presenting some certificates for us. Guys, after this, we're moving to the main awards. The awards is packed, I tell you. We have some special sponsors this year. And all the winners have 5-10 years. And the story will be different. We'll just present the last set of nominee certificates. There's a story that I want you guys to hear today from our keynote speaker to inspire you. Because a couple of you are starting. Okay, so to join us to present the next set of certificates, please join me as we make welcome Mr. Ben Tutu, a film director and filmmaker.
Akintola Muiz Aderemi, Hospitality and Tourism. Miriam Aramide, Hospitality and Tourism. Miriam Aramide, Hospitality and Tourism. Temitayo Fajujutumi, Technology. Temitayo Fajujutumi, Technology. Omoefe Akele, Fashion. Omoefe Akele, Fashion. Ola Sukomi Ola Dimeji, Ola Mike, Fashion. Please give them a round of applause. Ode Messi Princess, Fashion. Ode Messi Princess, Fashion. Emeka Mirelli, Fashion. Ejuka Johnson, Fashion. Ejuka Johnson, Fashion. Doisola Okunola, Fashion. Doisola Okunola, Fashion. Doimola Olajuwoni, Fashion. Doimola Olajuwoni.
Give you effect. I need to make sure that I have
Shoma
a second batch. That one batch. I need to
for
it.
Shoma
just stay on him like this. So if you want to reflect,
Chiamata Glory, Jonathan. Fashion.
Yes, so I want to see batch.
Chiamata Glory, Jonathan. Fashion.
Yeah.
What was it fair or Lafadi? Fashion. What was it fair or Lafadi?
Let's do it. Jump.
Professional services. Khadija Ibrahim Garuda, professional services.
She's tense, is anticipating, and she's just smiling. Why I am happy. So right now, I'll take you to the backstage and I'll get to interview the winners of each category. Join me and don't blink because you might miss the most important thing.
I'm gonna be like this. can't push the hand when you just come. Remember from where they come from. We're talking about the product of it on condom.
Round of applause for her.
May
Amazing. We also have Karika, who is the Vice President Programs Softcom. Please put your hands together for her.
All right. We also have Yomi Owope and Tewa Omosonya in the building.
And we have the one and only Larry Digo, co-founder of Dog Sports. Please put your hands together for him. And of course, I said earlier, we have the famous actor Ben Lugo Tuitu in the building.
Sorry.
It's an exciting night tonight. Yeah. And everyone is actually in the industry. Please put a round of applause together for yourself. Is it a round of applause together?
It's not rounds of applause for yourself, please. Clap as much as you want. You deserve it. Right about now, it's time for us to start with a welcome address by the founder of the SME 100, the person that has been putting this together for the past 6 years, the person that has sleepless nights, the person that makes sure that entrepreneurs have a voice, make sure they're seen, make sure they're recognized. I'm talking about the one and only Charles.
Hello everyone, good evening. I'm excited to welcome you all to the 6th edition of the Nigerian Philippine Women's Empowerment Award. And please give me some applause. And it's a pleasure on behalf of SME Women Africa to set the agenda. But because that, even if just acknowledge the people that the Nigerian Philippine Women's Empowerment Award 2021, please put your hands together for this guy. Okay, make some noise. We have some other special people. Last year was the cold year, so we didn't have this special dynamic. And so we have some people from the class of 2020. The class of 2020, I have to make some noise. Class of 2020. No, let's do that again. The class of 2020, and please make some noise. Okay, I'm just here to set the agenda to introduce you to some of my special friends who are here with us and some of the people who are behind tonight's edition of the Nigerian Philippine Women's Awards, and also just let you know what you should expect in the next few minutes. We'll do this for another 45 minutes, in an hour or more, we should be out of here. But I want to tell you about my dreams. Right. I think it was about 4 years ago, the President of the United States at the time, President Barack Obama, identified me and 16 others around the world who were doing amazing things. So there was me from Nigeria, there was some from Zimbabwe, there was some from Mongolia, there was some from Taiwan, from Lebanon, and you know, when I got a call from the US government at the time, I did not even know that the things that I was doing in Nigeria, somebody was watching. And so I think it's the same thing for many of you. We've been watching you guys for quite some time. And for many of you, we couldn't be in Samugari, in Kaduna, we couldn't be in Okigwe, in Imo State at the same time. So we went to social media, or we went to the internet, and we said to people, tell us people that you know in your locality who have been amazing things and contributed to social and economic development, and they brought us together. This is one of the projects. So we do this every year. People around Nigeria every year, looking for young people, under the age of 25, who have been amazing things and contributed to social and economic development in Nigeria. From sports, to education, to finance, to technology, to e-commerce, and many of these guys, you might not know them today. Do they know you guys? You might not know many of you guys today, but I can tell you that another 10 years, you'll be hearing their names. Is that a vow or anything tonight? In another 10 years, you'll be hearing their names. And so, we are taking it upon ourselves to identify these young people, because we see potential in these people. Many of you might be seeing a nobody today. Many of you might be seeing people who just want iPad, or one phone, from the bedroom of their houses or their garage or their kitchen, who are just, you know, amazing things, trying to make ends meet. Because many of them are frustrated. And as I start to speak with young people, I think some statistics, 600,000 young people are thrown out of education. So this is, federal education is polytechnic and university. 600,000 people are thrown out every year. Where are the jobs? Where are the jobs for these 600,000 people? I tell you what, these 600,000 people have work. Why? Because we have this young 25,000 people. Because I'm looking one time, and it's a call for application for jobs. And it's an organization, I'm not going to call the name of the organization. And they said, we're looking for only first class and 2 months. Those even job application that I said in the house, we're looking for only people who should have gone. So what happened to the people who went to ASU, to OSU, to do the lab? What happened to these people? And they're looking for 2 months and 2 months. So how they are looking for 2 months and first class? So how to the third class and 2 months? What's the name of these people? Guess what? Who is there? Why? Because they have the class of 2021 and class of 2022. See, the one who is there. And so, you know, myself and my team took it upon ourselves for 6 years. You know, it's a painstaking job. But somebody has to do it. Right? We go around Nigeria, we're doing this for 6 years now, and I just have a message for everyone here, right? My message tonight for you is to think big, start small, and go with it. Think big, start small, and go with it. Of course, when thinking big and starting small, there will be a lot of challenges. I'm discussing with a few friends of mine. I mean, there's many things to talk about, young people taking their lives, young people complete suicide, and the rate is going up by the day. And it was discriminating for me, it was terrible for me, because these are young people with potential. Well, because they're talking 1 note, or 2 notes, or 3 notes, they get discouraged. And that's the end for many of them. There's only 21 people. And you can ask them to move their team. I eat notes for breakfast. I just started to find out the amount of letters of all the notes that I'm getting. All the letters, you know those letters, I started to get out. Unfortunately, no, we thank you. How many people want to go? We thank you for applying, for taking time out of your busy schedule to apply. But, unfortunately, what's the other one? What? We regret, we do not get your answer. The Africans, I think they're Africans, I don't get that from your papers. Yes, and you know how it ends? We wish you all the best in your work. You guys are trusting me. But I'm saying this to say this, I said that to say this, right? Please don't get discouraged. My mechanism, my coping mechanism for this is, I have a very strong support system. When I get these notes, I think, my secretary in the office, go out with them, was there a family center, and I would in another packet, not show all the notes that I've gotten. But if they call somebody, to say that it's not the end of this. You get all these notes, but you have to keep going. I got the notes as well. I still get it. But it's not enough to take your life. Because there's a lot that's still ahead of you. There's a lot that you have to accomplish together. And I think, and I'm an opinion, that only young Nigerians can save Nigeria. Do you agree? That only young Nigerians can save Nigeria, right? And so, my second advice to you today, young people, is that you can't go out of the room. Even when Spider-Man combined, they can tie up the line. Get collaborations, get partnerships, talk to people. I told you that I made my first 15 million naira at the age of 21. And I did that because I knew the next person sitting next to me. So the AIC camp, I was playing for Portland at the time. And I went to AIC. And then you just saw when you were just sitting there where mommy market, you know, if you're a big one of girls in AIC, you don't need the food that AIC provides for you. You go to mommy market and invest in yourself. And that's why I met someone who actually even changed my life at that time. why you bring the nominee reception. Because you want people to collaborate. That's why you don't take more view to your WhatsApp group. Because you want to know the next person next to you. Because the next big break may not come from your parents, it may not come from your teacher, it may come from the person next to you. And so that's why we're doing these things. And all of you have been inducted into that group, and for the next 4 months, we're making a commitment that we're going to support you there regardless. You have unrestricted access to me or any member of my team. No matter who you need to reach, name that person who will have.
For that video.
Working. Can you guys hear me? Okay. Hi everyone. Congratulations to
Everyone, first of all, we'd just like to say that everybody here right now is a winner. So regardless of the 25 people that are going to walk home with something, everybody here, the fact that you are going against all odds to pursue your dreams, I mean, Nigeria is not like the most accommodating place for people to start businesses, for people to do their own thing. And in SoftCom, we have this philosophy where we have these two terms. So we call it the dreamers and the doers. Those are the people that are still thinking about doing certain things. Those are the ones that have changed their dreams into possibilities. Everyone here is a doer. So at SoftCom, we exist to provide solutions for business. Mostly small businesses, to help them grow and to help them scale. We have different products and programs that our VP Karika before speak about the Lift Business Program. We also have some products that you've seen outside there like Eyowo and Quicksell to help you facilitate the work that you do as entrepreneurs. And today, we also have this philosophy in SoftCom where we say that we want to be the partner of potential to people. There's this popular saying that is evenly distributed, but what we're trying to do in SoftCom is to provide people with these opportunities to help them scale and to help them grow. So today, the 25 people that are going to be walking away with 100,000 Naira each, they're also all going to get 6 months free subscriptions to all our products to help their businesses. You're all going to get access to capital for your business. And you're also going to get access to mentorship for in your own field as well with the LEAP program. So clap for yourselves. So the idea basically is that we need to be able to imbibe in people, we need to be able to give people back things to build themselves, to grow and to excel. Because it's only so much to just say, oh, you can do it, you can do it. If you don't give people things actually need to grow, then you're just talking. So that's what we're trying to do in SoftCom. We're trying to walk the walk and to do the work. So congrats to
everyone. We have, like I said to you guys, you know, the class of 2020 did not have the opportunity to experience this because of COVID, because of COVID here. Yeah, you guys here? Please come forward. Let me hear from them so that you can see if you can how to leverage this platform, some of their experiences, what they did. Come. As they come forward. Danny? Just keep clapping. The more you clap, the faster you can. Where you want in and what you've done with the platform last year. What's the idea to come and start working last year?
All right. Hi everyone. I am Oluwadam Molashriyobor and I won the software and design category last year for my company, the Creative Kids Zone. And basically what we do is train kids in technology skills at no cost. And so far, in the last 1 year, 25 of the 25 awards, winning it has opened us up to a lot of opportunities, from funding to mentorship, to be able to access partnerships that I wouldn't have been able to access on my own. And it was such a huge opportunity for me and for my team members at home. Thank you.
My name is Ayoto Mediolo Pleasure. I won the art and culture category. The last year's under 25 awards. In the last 100 people winning this award really helped me, like mentorship here, partnership. I really have access to like finance for my business. And you know, I think one very important thing that I had also was you know, having to meet like a CEO of AOU, having that intimate discussion, yes, within my team members, yeah. So that's been amazing actually, so thank you.
Good evening everyone, my name is Olufuke Folorunshaw. I won for the category of Citizenship and Government Engagement. I'm the founder of Streets of Africa, the non-government organization, and we provide solutions to the cost of sustainable SDG goals. 25, under 25 award has been so amazing. As a people winner, has been so amazing. This platform, I met a lot of people, I met a lot of personalities, and through this platform, the NGO able to get funds for the NGO. This is one of the highest funds we've gotten so far for the past 8 years in the NGO. So,
you can't even appreciate it to be here, but you know, and many of these people from one of my friends who, you know, came into this industry, came into an industry, I think, 6 years ago, if I'm not mistaken. In that industry, he suffered a lot of backlash. And, you know, I just want to ask any questions so that you guys will learn. We start to present the next set of awards. Please, with a round of applause, show it to Nobu, please. Now, Shay actually runs the biggest advertising agency in all of West Africa.
One of the biggest.
Okay, so I have two questions for you. You came into this advertising industry as a young man in your 20s, and now you can't count 5 advertising agencies in Nigeria without calling yours. How were you able to navigate that, because the advertising agency in Nigeria is like a cabal. How were you able to come in, scale, and be counted for one of the...
We're an out-of-home company. We're digital and out-of-home. How did we start, Lord said? I think my greatest and my biggest achievement is being able to get the team that I have today. Because without them, the company itself would never have been able to achieve what it's achieved today. On top of that as well, is listening to advices from uncles, friends, strangers, and also studying the market itself. It's very important to understand what you're going into and why you're going into it. And then again, understanding your competition. Because at the end of the day, if you are starting a business, you're a competition at the end of the day. And trying to figure out exactly what loopholes existed and lacunas that existed within the current market space. With regards to finance and scaling up, I think you asked me, it's gradual. A lot of people, one of the things I always tell people is this. Try not to raise too much funds to start with. And it's funny to say that, but one of the biggest issues I found with some of the businesses we started in initial stages that failed was we had access to cash, so we didn't quite understand the hardships that were necessary for one to build a company. Not just a business, but to actually build a company itself there. Can eventually run itself without you being around, and that's one thing you want to target and be able to do. Start small, scale up, and never ever forget that you know you're still in competition with every other person. So don't get too comfortable. In other words, don't start thinking because I am bigger than this person. Then I should relax. I mean, every day when we wake up, we start our strategy meetings, and I always tell my staff, I am only restricted to a certain particular area in Lagos. If they're able to identify new locations for us around Nigeria as a whole, because Loadside has actually grown into a company now that we're in 10 different states around Nigeria. You know, and the reason why we're able to still operate even in Port Harcourt or in Kano or in Kaduna is simply because of the fact that we have staff there that also identify for us. So we listen from the drivers to the head of the department to just a regular salesperson. So it's a cohesive kind of cooperation arrangements, I guess.
Just one last question. You started on a deal of 10, right? Your 20s when you started?
29, 28.
Yeah, so many of these guys are under 25. What is that thing that you want to say to them that you learned, and then if you could tell yourself when you started, you would have made a big impact in your life?
Never give up. Never allow someone else to tell you that you're dreaming too big. But I think the most important thing is crawl before you try and run. And it's very easy for one to say that there is no challenge that is too hard for you to overcome. There are definitely challenges you will overcome, and there's some that would set you back. But those ones that set you back are usually the best learning curves and learning experiences. If you fail with one, pick up again and try again. If that doesn't work, then try and find out, you know, what else or what you did wrong or what other passion, which other area that you feel you can accomplish and achieve something. Do not allow social media to also put you down with negative comments or in them, but listen to them. Listen to your customers, listen to your clients. You're not smarter than them, and you're trying to provide a service for them, so you have to make sure that their negative comments are the ones that you also use to improve your business and eventually get to where you want to get. And by God's grace, all the future entrepreneurs up there look forward to being on the same round table with you, and your company is also growing, and I wish you all the best of luck.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Shay. Okay, on that note, hold on, please, can you pause this? I'll start it again. Play it again.
It's in that single spark of genius. It happens when you least expect it. Potential is not some grand big idea. Potential is in that conversation that starts with, what if we could? What if we could all see the potential everywhere, all around us? Everyone all over to know their worth, to help them reach their goal.
We can, because when you find your partner of potential, nothing can stop you.
Right? I don't know if you love that ad. So let me explain that ad. That lady you saw in the ad is Azizat Oshola. She's the captain of the females Super Falcons team. She's the first African to win the UEFA Champions League. She's the four-time BBC African footballer of the year. But she's all that now because somebody saw a potential in her. Who was her grandmother, right? Her grandmother that time encouraged her to play football. And then she would go, I think it was somewhere around Lagos Island. She would go and she would play and she would train and she would train. And today, she's all of this. But I can tell you that Aziza would not be this if somebody did not see potential in her. We, at SME 100 Africa, at SOFCOM, at LOSAD, at Exquisite Magazine, at Shakara Kuto, we see potential in all of you. And that's why we're here today to celebrate all of you. And we will not stop any length until we make sure that your success. So, God bless you, the class of 2021.
So this could be your story. If you want that, say A. Oh, you don't want that. Okay. If you want that, say A. Alright, that's right. And I was thinking of how, you know, this could be the beginning of a beautiful, beautiful story. So, this is an encouragement that Charles started from somewhere, and you guys can start from somewhere as well, or you've already even started from somewhere, and then the sky is just the starting point. Now, I also heard some of the things that you guys are winning. Y'all are lucky! You guys are winning cash prizes, you're winning so many opportunities, mentorships. Please, a round of applause for 25 Under 25 Award. Yeah. That was really amazing. Thank you so much to all our keynote speakers. It is now time. It is the moment that we have all been waiting for. Ladies and gentlemen, is your heart beating? Is your heart beating? Are you worried? Are you confident? Don't worry, you're gonna be fine. I'm just teasing you for another extra 1 minute, trying to get your blood pressure up a little bit, you know, because it's a very big deal, and I want you to come here and be super, super excited. And I have the honor of presenting the first set of awards. My co-host, ladies and gentlemen, put together your hands for Victory Wilson! You're welcome.
Wow, wow, amazing, amazing. I heard all the prizes that the winners are going home with tonight, and it's just fantastic. Please put your hands together for Softcom, our partners tonight. I mean, a whooping sum of 100,000 each, 6 months free subscription, mentorship. Can you get this anywhere else than 25 under 25? No or yes? No! So put your hands together for 25 under 25 awards! Okay, without wasting much of our time, it is now time for the presentation of the first set of awards. And to do this, please make welcome Mrs. Mushirafat Abiola, who is the regional coordinator of LIRS Victoria Island Lagos. Please put your hands together for her. So she will be presenting the awards for active citizenship and government engagement, education, and agriculture. Meet the nominees for Active Citizenship and Government Engagement.
And the nominees for Active Citizenship and Government Engagement are Ojuma Jerry Elizabeth Hoffman, Samuel Adeyinkaowa, Save Southern Ishiko, Olaya Samuel Ajay, Project Africa Now, Kamaru Dean, Street Dog Tap, Beru J. Marianne, Daughters of Africa.
Good evening, everyone. The winner is...
I'm going to go to the hospital.
to come. Balaku Ivan. Balaku come.
Good evening, everyone. It's my pleasure to be here. Thanks, and I'm glad I cleared or opened the gateway. Congratulations to everyone of us. Big ups to us. I just have something quickly to say. I run Project Africa now, a youth-led intended organization using media amongst battles to drive and inspire young Africans towards creating positive change. Every one of you share the same burning desire and passion for our great continent and our country. And the truth remains that it is in the hands of we young people to help ourselves. So I'm appealing to every young person, accomplished ones and those on the way to reaching great heights, please, as much as you can, give opportunities, as much as you can, lend that help to that young person around you. Please, we have ourselves to get ourselves out of this, and I believe that we shall rise again. I believe that we shall rise again. Thank you very much.
Is the award for education. Meet the nominees.
And the nominees for education are Blessing Adam, the Innovative Child Network for Skill-Based Education. Shino Ajoyi, Different Maker Corporation. Faith Moyosori Abona, AFN Stories Limited. Farouk Palumi Yahaya, Farouk Yahaya Innovations. Juliet E.K., Maverick Skill Hub. Akinti Aramide, Talent Mind Foundation.
The winner is... The winner for the difference is... Maker Corporation, Shino Ajoyi. In recognition of your performance, this certificate is presented to you, Shino Ajoyi, Differences Made Corporation. Congratulations.
Before this award ceremony, I was actually nominated for the radio session, and it was very, 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 very funny to me because I was just like every other nominee, and the better was the radio session, and I had to come all the way from my birth paper. I had an exam that week. My name is my mate in the school. I had to come all the way, look up, I did not come here. I want to say to everybody here, please, my dream has always been to really responsible effect on accountability leaders to make significant difference in all aspects of life, and I believe solely that education is an equalizer. Education is an equalizer. So in everything you're doing, please get educated. Get educated. And keep educating the world. Please. Thank you.
Greatness.
Shino, you are really a difference maker. I mean, you came with all your crew. A big congratulations to you, Shino. Please put your hands together for you one more time.
Greatness.
Okay. The next category is... The
nominees for agriculture are Bamidele Abimad, Bambi Farms and Agro Consult, Matthias Mantra Paul, fresh from the farm agri world, Agweka Daniel Victor, Major Enterprises, Adefalu Rekiat Omolola, co-founder Adebola Foods, Aja Onyebuchi Frank, Ofarge Agro Services, Timothy A. Adekunle, the Treasurer Agriculture and Fisheries, Olamide Ojolu, Oaks Farm Limited, Onwe Kusi Olisa Emeka Emmanuel, Olix Farm, Miriam Yakubu Yana, Mainstream Limelight Limited, Eke Ohabuduro, Edge Green Farm Enterprise, Doinjola Okunola, Smilabella, Akande Feijayo, Syllable Limited, Israel Alabi, Farm Speed Technology Limited, Joy Badaki, Became Foods Limited.
Wow, I would say this award I got is as a support from everyone, aside from those who nominated me and those who voted for me, and also this is how. What did you say?
All right, congratulations. I just want to let you know that being a winner, we have this winner's dance. It's a special dance. I have to do what I do. So it goes thus. Can you give me that? Yes, you have to do that. Sorry. You have to do that.
I have to do that.
So are you ready?
Okay.
One, two, ready, go. See what she's doing.
I'm really about that.
All right, thank you so much. Enjoy the evening.
All right. Congratulations to all our winners. I mean, that is some fantastic stuff right there. I couldn't be more proud. Without wasting any more of your time, we're going to the next set of awards. And this one is going to be presented by the CEO of Lotsad Promo Media. And that is the one and only Sheyi Tinubu. Yes, a round of applause. You can do better, you can do better. Awards in the category of media and communications, in the category of manufacturing and logistics, in the category of hospitality and tourism, in the category of social entrepreneurship, and in the category of professional services. Thank you so much.
I work for Africa Tech Radio. It's an online radio station, and online radio is not really popular in Nigeria right now, but I've been able to push Africa Tech Radio to where it is right now. I also host a conference for radio presenters, What is Radio? I bring together the beautiful presenters from all over Nigeria to come train young people that do not know anything about radio but want to make a name for themselves in radio. I do all of this without collecting a dime. I run it by my own expenses. I'm super excited to win this because I know it's going to change my life, change my career, and move things forward. To everyone out there thinking that it cannot make it, thinking that media and communication is a difficult path to tread, I want you to know that you can do it. If I can do it, you can do it. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Nigeria. Thank you to all the nominees, everybody who voted. My dad, oh boy, my dad was on Facebook, and oh my God. Thank you, Daddy. I know you're really watching this right now. To my younger brother, Samuel Olufeko. Thank you, everybody. I'm grateful. Let's do this.
Congratulations, Gloria.
Have to hustle on Facebook for votes. It's not easy. You are busy. Alright, still on presenting the awards.
Now for the winner in media and communication. They are not ready. Like, I am super excited. Congratulations, Gloria Olufeko. Like, this is a whole lot. How much work have you put into winning this award?
Okay, first, it was a great deal for me.
Wow.
It's my first time trying, and I thought about it. I said, okay, I've done a lot in media and communication. I think I deserve to be recognized for it.
Exactly.
Giving my time, giving everything I can to ensure that radio presenters around me find a way they can carve a niche for themselves. Yeah. What is Radio is just starting. I'm hoping to take this and leverage this further. Many thanks to Africa Tech Radio for the platform. Beautiful platform. Thank you, Africa Tech Radio, for this. I can't contain my joy. SME 125/25. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for this. It was a struggle getting here, but I'm grateful. Gratitude is all I feel right now. I'm so grateful.
Congratulations once again. Like, I don't know why I feel like I share in your happiness, because I won for the media category last year. That's 20. So it's like I'm passing on to you.
Absolutely.
Congratulations.
2020 winner. In the category of manufacturing and logistics,
the nominees for manufacturing and logistics are Wonye Yeji, Catherine Okeji, Keys Creation, Miriam Arakunle, McToy's Integrated Services, Bobo Debbie SA, Aces and Dabs Creative, Chioma Upabi, Katsola, Katso Designs. And the winner is Chioma Upabi.
For 3 years now, people always like still the reason to nominate my business. So I'm a shoemaker. I make handmade shoes for both male and female. And people always say reason to nominate capsule design for the past 3 years now. And I want to dedicate this award to everyone that's always believed in my business, from my mom, to my boyfriend, to my friend, to my customer. God and to honor 25 awards for putting this up. And yes, I'm ready for the journey. So thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Excited. Let's start with, I love your outfit. You look nice.
Thank you so much.
Wow, how do you feel winning this award?
Okay, so I'm feeling nervous. I have stage fright, but I'm super excited. Like, now I know people really have believed in Katsu, and I promise not to let them down. Like, the ginger just came up again.
Wow,
like,
ginger swagger.
I'm actually really ready to, like, move to the next level.
So if I may ask, how much work did you put to get this award?
From having to stay online at a particular time, because then it was a 24-hour thing, so everyone had to like vote at the same time. From calling people, going on Facebook, my mom, my boyfriend, my customers, like people were really, really, really out there trying to
Wow, you really tried, and I must say congratulations. And before you go, I would like you to give me a winner's dance. Just dance and I'll just do something. Come on, I'm a king. I see this excitement. All right, enjoy the rest of your evening. Bye. I'm a king. I'm the best in the nation.
Hi, congratulations to Chioma. God, well, oh, are we in together? Oh, I didn't know that. All right, in the next category of hospitality and tourism.
And the nominees for hospitality and tourism are Oluwa Seun Rotimi, Esther Touch Madigan, Doyinsola Okunola, Smile Adele, Lydia Osagiyewa, Uwaku Okunuta, Adeo Leche, Miriam Aramide, Matoy Integrated Service, Akintola Reeve Adereme, Prestige Integrated Project Limited, Shobola Demola Andrew, Demola Drew, Ayodeji for the two, Careers and Business Everything, Ogumu Yero Moimi Olua KP Magazine, Oyekunle Esther, E. Bera Events.
The winner is Mary Mahoney for My Choice Security Services.
Good evening.
Oh. It's been a really nice time that you can so I'm here. Thank you.
Okay. In the next category of social entrepreneurship,
the nominees are
social media. Who is doing this thing? Please, one yourself. Abeg. Oh yeah, I was joking now.
Innovation Developmental Organization. Doton Famorio. Oluwole Olushola. Oluyori Business Enterprise. Zeta Chizetere Ejike. Ademuyiwa Osayo. Baba Sola Oduwase. Abdullahi Ademola Osinuba. God's gift, Ajoma Fuwe Febo. Ogun Moyero Moyero.
Now, I said earlier, if you are the winner of media and communications, I believe that's Gloria. If you want in manufacturing and logistics, please, as I'm calling your name, can you come up on stage? All right. If you also want in hospitality and tourism, if you want in social entrepreneurship, and of course, Ayodeji, our winner in professional services, please come on stage. You can come with your placard, that's fine. You have it. All right. So we have three, two more people. Who are we missing?
Ladies and gentlemen.
We need one more person. Now I'll take it again. If you want in media and communications, manufacturing and logistics, hospitality and tourism, social entrepreneurship and professional services. That is five people. You don't want to miss this one though. Who is missing?
If you get a woman hold on tight, me and my guys sitting for Bible. My allocation thing for mine.
Alright. So I'm gonna have a very short pass for you. Mr. Charles is wondering what's going on. You'll have to leave. Okay, he has given me to go ahead. Can I go ahead? Do you guys want to see this drama? Okay now. So before you can actually participate in this drama, you need to actually put on your dancing shoes. I said it earlier, come with your mini dance. You look very serious. I don't want to offend my mother, my father. You will dance to the... Yeah, I'm gonna dance today. So DJ, for the next 30 seconds, we want to see their winning dance.
$300,000 each. giving each of you 10 million naira's worth of ad space on any of my sites.
Gotta turn it.